Washington Square sits at the base of Quarry Hill and the intersection of Beacon and Washington Streets. In 1657, when the road to Watertown was laid out, small houses began to dot the landscape. However, well into the 19th century, it remained sparsely populated. It wasn't until the late 19th century, when Beacon Street was laid out, and eventually widened, that Washington Square witnessed immense development, comprising numerous houses, apartments, and business blocks. With increased population, the area has become a center of commerce, providing restaurants and other services to the community. In the mid-19th century, with Brookline Village the municipal and commercial center of Brookline, much of the rest of the town remained a spattering of farmland, marshland, and pastures. In 1851, when Beacon Street was laid out, the newly formed intersection with Harvard Street experienced minor growth, with a few houses and small buildings constructed. A few years later, David Coolidge's general store was built on the corner. Coolidge's Corner soon became an outpost for goods and other services. When Olmsted widened Beacon Street in the 1880s, the area subsequently witnessed residential and commercial growth, as exemplified by the business and apartment blocks and single-family houses constructed. Additionally, with the streetcar enhancing access to the area, it became the commercial center of the entire town. In 1892, Coolidge's store was purchased by Wallace Pierce as a place to sell groceries and other imported items. In 1898, the S.S. Pierce Building was erected approximately on this site. Earlier photographs show the tower itself to have had a different roof. Damaged in a 1944 hurricane, the building and the tower in particular were renovated. Its belfry now enclosed, the tower stands slightly shorter than its original design. With Coolidge Corner's growth, the corridor northward along Harvard Street soon experienced development as well. David McKay and Peter Graffam were two of North Brookline's chief developers, producing houses for small business owners, doctors, and other individuals with managerial positions who required daily commutes to Boston and more affordable houses. In 1914, the Kennedy family had purchased a house on Beale Street. John Kennedy was born there 3 years later. They moved to another house nearby in 1921. Today it is part of the JFK Birthplace National Historic Site, preserving the house and its interior for future generations. Another period of intense development in Coolidge Corner and North Brookline occurred in the 1920s and 30s. A multitude of concrete buildings commercial blocks, and apartment rises were constructed during this time, of classical and Art Deco design. They displaced many of the single-family houses that had lined Beacon Street. A number of these include the Coolidge Corner Arcade Building, which was built in the late 1920s with a cast stone facade. The Art Deco Bank Building was built in the 1920s. Today it houses Bank of America. The Coolidge Corner Theater Building was built in 1906, originally as the Universalist Church. It became a theater in 1933 and still operates as such today. In 1906, a Baptist church was built along Beacon Street. Displaced in 1971 by a concrete office building, the memory of the church is preserved as its bell sits on display in the courtyard. Also prominent in the Coolidge Corner and North Brookline neighborhoods is the significant influence of Jewish culture. It is estimated about 35% of Brookline residents is Jewish, with much of the concentration in this area. Beginning in the 1920s, a number of Jewish communities relocated their temples and centers to Brookline. In 1925, Kehilat Yisrael was built on Harvard Street, across from Beale Street. Two years later, Temple Ohabe Shalom opened on Beacon and Kent Streets. In 1944, the Second Unitarian Church, originally built in 1916, became Temple Sinai. These are just a few among other synagogues which stand as testaments to the Jewish communities that have established Brookline as their home. With its vibrant and diverse community, to its bustling corridors of storefront windows and active streetcars, to the modern yet elegant buildings that surround the neighborhood, with the delicate and ornate edifices of the Art Deco, to the solid pediments and imposing columns of the neoclassical, to the unassuming timber frame design, Coolidge Corner has preserved a snapshot of Brookline from the turn of the 20th century, more specifically of the 1920s. It continues to this day to serve the town as its cultural and commercial center. One of the town's oldest structures is the Edward Devotion House. Edward Devotion had been one of Brookline's earliest settlers and owned property on Harvard Street by 1650. It remained in his family for many years after his death. One descendant, Edward Devotion Jr., willed that upon his death the land be used for public education, and in that spirit, the Devotion School today stands behind the house. The house itself was built in 1740, but an older frame exists dating back to 1680. It was sold to various owners in the 18th and 19th centuries before being purchased by the town in 1891. It has been used as the headquarters of the Brookline Historical Society since 1901. The Edward Devotion House serves as a modest reminder of Brookline's agricultural past, once dominated by farmlands and pastures, today flanked by houses, residential buildings, and corridors of commerce and business. It is no longer desired by farmers as an area to raise their cattle and livestock, but the town has managed over the years to retain a certain appeal. With its green spaces, public transit, and sidewalk communities, Brookline has adapted to the needs for further investment and development, while preserving a sense of simplicity and dignity in a humble manner that dates back to its founding centuries ago. A small town, Brookline has balanced the needs of the future with the values of its past.